Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now going back up to the surface, finally. I'm torn between either clicking this or just telling Imoen, let's go.
Such menial tasks.
We've done what we came to do. Time to head back to the palace for a well-earned rest, don't you think?
Yeah, sounds like we're going right to the Ducal Palace from here. Yes, let's return to the palace.
Thank you, gods, it's done! It's over. It's finally over. Saravok's allies are all dead, or awaiting the noose. What will you do now?
No spoilers, guys, but somehow I don't think Saravok's allies are all dead. Well, maybe Saravok's allies, but definitely not all the Baal spawn. What will I do now? I'm still gonna sleep for a week. Okay. Seek new ways to expand my power. Yeah, we deserve it. First, I'm gonna sleep for a week, then another week, then a month, and after that, I'll probably have a nap.
I'm glad you're all right. I worry about you.
I worry about you too, Imoen. If I were to lose you, I don't know what I'd do.
Let's never find out, all right?
Deal.
Corlage is defeated, and the last of Saravok's influence died with her. Your foster father, Gorion, has been avenged. With the exception of your friend Imoen, those who helped you thwart your half-brother's schemes drift away from you, returning to their lives. For the first time since you left Candlekeep, you have the opportunity to reflect on the astonishing turns your life has taken. Though you are fettered by the rulers of Baldur's Gate, a sense of unease plagues you. You can't help but hear the rumors, the whispers that you share the same dark blood as Saravok. Some hint you killed your half-brother, not for the good of the city, but so you could usurp his place and his power. For the moment, however, your persecutors' voices are drowned out by an ever-growing number of others with more immediate concerns. Every day, more refugees driven from their homes by the servants of Kalar Argent arrive at the city gates. Many have stories of the Shining Lady's grace. All have tales of her followers' wrath. Atende, after Korlaj's defeat, you retire to your chamber in the Ducal Palace, your thoughts troubled. You wonder what effect Kalar's crusade will have on Baldur's Gate, little knowing how close at hand the answer is.
So it's Corlage and Ducal Palace. I kind of like Ducal Palace, though. What just fell? Sounds like I fell out of bed.
Heya! You awake? It's me, Imoen.
Echoing the beginning of Baldur's Gate itself, she still doesn't sound quite like the old Imoen. Well, I guess she's older now, a little more tempered, a little more mature. No, I'm not awake. I'm awake now.
Good. I need to talk about what's going on. Maybe I'm just jumpy because of what's been going on in the city. There's so many people here running from that crusade in the north. I thought I heard noises outside my room. I was worried something was happening.
Noises? What kind of noises?
Footsteps, maybe muttering. It was probably just a servant. Hells, now I feel silly.
No, trust your instincts.
Wait, there it is again. Did you hear that? I'm gonna go check it out.
I didn't hear anything, but the music is playing along now. Maybe that's why. Be careful, Imoen. I should look for the treasure of Phyllis in the royal basement. My missed fortune? I should look for the treasure of Phyllis in the Ducal Palace's basement. Yes, I'm still saying Ducal Palace. When I began my stay at the palace, I deposited my gold in the basement vault. I can recover it by visiting the palace treasurer. Oh, I'm all alone. Yeah, they did mention that, but I don't want to lose Minsk and Kagan and Branwyn and... And Dinah here. The other one, Stefana, can come and go. I really don't care. Okay, I deposited my gold in the basement vault. I can recover it by visiting the palace treasurer, Ophilus, who can generally be found in a small room on the basement's south side. Ophilus also supplied me with a chest to store items of value, which may prove useful. It is currently in my quarters at the palace. Yeah, 314 pi. Is this my quarters? So wait, I have nothing. I have my familiar. I have a treasury note. The wealth you accumulated since departing Candlekeep has been stored in the palace basement by the treasurer of Phyllis. Presenting this receipt, meticulously inscribed on delicate parchment, will allow you to withdraw your gold. A personal note has been written at the bottom of the receipt. Dear Sapphire, as I have not heard otherwise, I'm guessing the chest I had delivered to your quarters to store your friend's equipment is getting the job done. Oh, all their stuff is in there. That's good, because I wouldn't be able to carry all that, but it's good that it is there, I'm assuming. It is all in there. Please do let me know if it isn't, and I'll have another sent to you immediately. Regards... Oh. I'll copy the note, because I always do that. Okay, zero. Gold... I have everything memorized, I'm assuming, because I slept. Alright.
A simple matter.
Yeah, it's all here. Well, I can't tell from that. But there is quite a bit here. Give me that for even Safana's leather armor. I guess everyone just walked out of here naked. What happened? Where'd it go? Oh. I can't double click. Shift click? Oh. I have to carry 15. Let me take. Couple wands. I don't know what that key is for. I wanted to go and sell a lot of this stuff. Okay,
this
stuff
is so utterly boring.
Well, you're going through your things as necessary. Not everything is here.
This is so utterly boring.
Like, what happened to... What happened to my scroll case? Okay, so I have... Oh, this is an empty gem bag. This is Safana's gem bag. Like, it's just carrying the stuff just in case. Take that one, that's more charges. Let's say put this one back. Okay. Below you, the streets of Baldur's Gate are so packed it's difficult to make out individual figures. This appears to go down, but we can't go. Oh no!
Keep back! I'm warning you! Come any closer and I'll...
Cut her down!
I'm trying to pause. Wait. Okay, we've got... Assassin? Did she kill that one? Oh, she cast a magic missile.
What?
Well, I can do that too. Another assassin.
Yes.
The hero is here. Take him.
What is it? A simple matter.
Are you here? The palace is under attack and... Oh, hells.
Corwin? Where is she? Oh. Here? The assassin says, another guard! Put her down, quick!
What? Fine. Yes? Fine. What fine?
That was unnecessary. Parchment. She's not dead.
You all right?
I'll live, but my friend Imoen requires aid. At least I hope she can get aid at this point. A healer should be here soon.
Forgive me. I'm Shale Corwin, Captain, Flaming Fist. Enemy forces penetrated the palace. I tried to reach you before they did, but... well...
I'd probably like to hear this story if my best friend wasn't dying.
Fenster, the palace cleric, is working his way up, assisting the wounded as he goes. Your friend doesn't look too bad.
Define too bad.
No. Best not to risk it. I'll find Fenster and get him up here.
Thank you. Wait, where are we both going away? Oh. Leah Janath. She's one of the Dukes. Corwin and Flaming Fist Enforcer. Did she not die, though?
Imoen, are you here, girl?
She is here, Grand Duke Janath. But she needs help.
Let me see her.
I think she died in my playthrough. And Belt lived? Trying to remember. Wasn't that long ago? True. But, yeah, I'm pretty sure she died and Belt lived. Against the shapeshifters. The scene of Saravak's inauguration.
Fenster and the other healers are dealing with the wounded downstairs. I've some knowledge of the healing arts and a few potions. Perhaps I can be of assistance.
Whatever you can do to help Imoen, please. Just let me know how I can help.
The assassin's blades are coated with a mystic poison, but I believe I can save her.
Believe? You can't manage something a little more encouraging than that?
There is no certainty to be had in this world. I will do everything in my power to restore her.
See that you do.
The best thing you can do right now is accompany Captain Corwin downstairs and ensure the palace is secure.
Of course, m'lady. I'll give you a moment to recover yourself and await you on the second floor.
Thank you. Just want to take a look at this parchment. Inside this folded piece of parchment is a passingly accurate rendering of the face of Sapphire, hero of Baldur's Gate. I don't know why I'm copying all these, but I am nonetheless. Well, okay.
What?
Imoen lies still on the floor. Her chest rises and falls. She lives. That's all you can be sure of. For now, it will have to be enough. It is not enough, damn you.
Fine.
Hello?
We're more than mercenaries.
If you say so. Assassins in the High Hall. How could this have happened? There's nothing you can do to help here, Sapphire. Go downstairs and speak with Duke Elton. He may have learned something of our attackers.
We're more than mercenaries.
Everything all right, ma'am? I awoke to a killer in my own quarters, and my friend may not survive the night. What do you think? Dark circumstances indeed, these. Whoever's behind this attack, their lives won't be worth a copper once Grand Duke Belt finds them. Yeah, I hope so. Can I look at these books, I hope? The History of Arm. Don't I have a History of Arm? It's so long ago, I'm gonna look at my notes here. Oh, history. I'd be surprised if I didn't have a history of Arm. Oh, there is two pages of this I have. Looking through here. Quite a bunch of books. And they all start with the word history. I do. Found it in a commoner's house in Olgot's beard. History of Waterdeep 1. That I remember reading. Anything else that someone may have dropped or anything like that? So she walked in here, or she's... I wonder if I should get more stuff. Oh, here's my key ring. Here's my, potion case and my other thing. Didn't show up before. Unless I think I was, like, sitting here, and that was up there. I don't know. So I grabbed... Put this one back. No, I can't. Okay. That one is 15 charges. On magic missiles. Yeah, I'm starting to get overweight. Now I can't seem to split them up. I was not harmed at all, so Hopefully I don't regret this. But I want to be able to carry things without just dropping stuff. So it's funny. It's a key, but I can't go on the key ring. Oh, I got two now. Do the bags themselves have a weight? I didn't mean to pick up the other gem bag here. So I'm going to drop this, these potions, and this gem bag. Make sure this is the correct one. Yes. Okay, good. I don't know why I wanted all my gems, but just in case. Okay. I wonder if this is more of our stuff. I mean, I'll take the identify scroll. And that. Wand. It's another wand of magic missiles. Oil of speed. It's not going to be helpful for just me. Yeah, this is probably Imoen's stuff, actually. It is her stuff. I don't know what she was doing. Well, that's right. This is all Imoen stuff that she had from the end of the first Baldur's Gate. So this is new because she was learning how to be a mage. Makes sense. I can probably identify this with lore. Yeah. One of magic missiles with 10 charges. Imoen's room. Good to know. Even with the window closed, the dull roar of the crowded street outside is hard to ignore. No. Just curious, that's the only way down? Because it looks like there's also... There is! Alright, let's take the way down in my room. I don't know why I'm choosing that, necessarily.
To arms! There are more assassins about.
That's Corwin. Alright, so we got assassin. We've got some Flaming Fist Enforcers.
Yes?
If these are like the same ones we had... Kill her! Cut the fish shrew down. Corwin took care of that guy.
Is that all of them?
I believe so.
The council will want to know you're all right. We should get downstairs. Let's go.
Okay, you guys all right?
We're more than mercenaries.
Whoever attacked the palace will pay a heavy price. Mark my words. They're marked. What's on the table here? Okay, I got a bottle of wine. The label on this wine bottle reads Marcember Blush, fine vintage. It claims to be a fruity blend of spices and dew flower fragrances. The vineyards of Marcember are well known for their firm grapes, which draw their flavor from the fragrant salt air of the Sea of Fallen Stars. See, just looking at this wine makes me like I'm drunk and unable to speak. Here I have another one of them. Same vintage. So these people haven't dropped anything? Beyond the courtyard of the Ducal Palace stretch the crowded, airy streets of Baldur's Gate. Travel through the dense crowds looks all but impossible. Alright. Can I look in these rooms, or do I have to follow her? Let's hope I don't get in trouble here. Okay. We got some special arrows. Oh god! Yeah, I'm in trouble. I won't outlive the day.
What? Yes?
I don't have a quarterstaff. Ow.
Such menial tasks.
Let me see it come out here. The guards will help me a little bit. Oh, chunks. Takes care of that. Yeah, that wasn't all of them. Good thing I took a lot of healing potions. I could have used my ability, but I'd prefer to save that, if possible. History of the North 1. I've read that. I might have been able to come out the same way I went in, I'm not sure. Alright. Just looking for like question marks or like interactable objects. Okay, so I'm assuming this goes back up to Imoen's room.
Fine. A simple matter.
All right, so these are arrows plus one. Skull case is full. Yeah, you can't zoom in with these segments.
Let us begin. You know your host, Duke Belt, and Grand Dukes L10 and Entar Silvershield, I believe.
Grand Duke Silvershield, weren't you... Forgive me if this is indelicate, weren't you killed? And weren't you killed as well, Leo Janath?
It took all of Fanster's skills to restore me to life, but we are not here to discuss my health.
don't think he had that accent before.
What do you know of the so-called Shining Lady, Kalar Argent?
Sapphire. Why do you ask?
I examined the body of one of the assassins. A sun cresting the horizon was branded upon his forearm.
The symbol of Kalar Argent and her cursed crusade.
The crusade is in Baldur's Gate? I thought they were only active north of the Winding Water.
They were. Something has changed. The crusade has disrupted trade all along the Sword Coast. Hundreds, thousands have been driven from their homes, their fields and storehouses ransacked. Some weeks ago, we dispatched 100 Flaming Fists to join with soldiers of Waterdeep and Daggerford and march on Kalar's stronghold, Dragonspear Castle.
100 Flaming Fists and the soldiers of Waterdeep and Daggerford? It's quite an assembly.
It won't be enough. The Crusade's ranks have swelled. After the Iron Crisis, the fists are already stretched perilously thin. Even so, we're sending every sword we can muster north.
Leah says, we would have you join them. The hero of Baldur's Gate is once again called upon to defend the city. I stand ready to answer that call.
Excellent. I knew our faith in you was not misplaced.
Sapphire.
There is one other thing you should know. I took this parchment from one of the assassin's bodies. It's a passable likeness of you. I'm sure you'll agree.
Yeah, it must be the same portrait that we saw. Yeah. Lovable. I found one just like it. So I was the assassin's target.
You need not go alone. The fist shall back you. And more as well, if you wish.
What's an improvement from before, when they chased me all over the streets of Baldur's Gate?
I know the whereabouts of your old allies. Some of them, anyway. The captain here can escort you to them.
So we're headed to the nearest tavern, I presume?
A couple of them, if you'd like. I'll be at the main doors when you're ready to go.
You're doing Baldur's Gate a great service. We'll not forget it.